Hello everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about parity that is used in RAID. Now RAID stands for Redundant Array of Independent Disks. In a RAID setup with parity, the data is striped or spread across multiple disks. So in the event of a disk failure, no data loss will occur. And the reason why no data loss would happen is because of something that we call parity. And parity is information that is used to rebuild the data in the event of a disk failure. Hey guys, before I continue, I just want to thank our sponsor for this video, which is Brilliant. Brilliant is an online learning center where you can learn different topics in a fun and interactive way. With over 1,000 lessons available, their way of teaching is effective because you're not just reading from a book or watching a video. But instead, you're involved in doing the exercises yourself, which makes learning easier. With courses from computer science, coding, engineering, or even cryptocurrency, you can be assured that you'll find something that you're interested in learning about. So for example, you want to learn about computer memory? Brilliant has 26 lessons that show how data is retrieved from a computer, how memory is laid out, and computer memory architecture. So forget about boring lectures or reading a book. Brilliant makes learning fun and effective in learning skills that are in demand today. And right now you can try everything that Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 30 days by going to brilliant.org/powercert or click the link in the description below, and you'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription. So as an example, a very common RAID setup is RAID 5. And in order to use RAID 5, you need to have 3 or more disks. So in a RAID 5 setup, the data is striped or spread across the disks. And in addition to the stored data, parity is also evenly spread across all the disks. So the next question is, how does parity work? Well, data is written to disks in ones and zeros. So here we have 1 byte of data, which is 8 bits. And here we have 3 disks in a RAID 5 setup. So as a very simplified example, let's just say that RAID 5 will store 4 bits of this data on disk A and the other 4 bits on disk B. And then it will use disk C to store parity. And the way parity is calculated is by using what's called an XOR calculation, which is displayed on this chart, which simply means that if both digits are the same, then the parity is 0. Or if both digits are different, then the parity is 1. So the way to do this is that we look at the first bit on each disk and calculate them. So for example, the first bits on both disks are 1s, so they are the same, which means that the first bit in the parity disk would be a 0. The second bits on each disk are 0s, so they are also the same, which means that the second bit for parity would also be a 0. Now, the third bits on each disk are a 0 and a 1, so they are different. And since they are different, the parity would be a 1. And the fourth bits on each disk are also different. We have a 1 and a 0, which means that the output would also be a 1. So here is the parity information for this byte of data, and it's with this information that is used to rebuild the data if a disk crashes. So for example, let's say that one of the disk drives crashes, but since we're using RAID 5, no data would be lost because RAID 5 can rebuild the data if a single disk crashes. So now we can remove the drive and then replace it with a new one. And we're going to use the information on drive A and the parity on disk C to rebuild the data that was lost on disk B. And the way to do this is just like we did before, using the same XOR calculation. So if we look at the first bits on disk A and disk C, we have a 1 and a 0, and they are different, which means that the first bit in our new disk would be a 1. And then we look at the second digits, which are the same, so the second bit in our new disk drive would be a 0. And then the third digits are different, so that would equal a 1. And finally, the fourth bits are the same, which would equal a 0. So as you can see, the data has been restored and it matches the original data. So that's how parity is used to restore the data. And this works no matter which of these disks fail. So it doesn't matter as long as no more than one disk fails at a time. Because as I said before, RAID 5 can only handle one disk failure at a time. Now, keep in mind, the Parity is not kept on one drive. Instead, it's equally spread across all the disk drives, like you see here, which is why it can rebuild the data regardless of which drive fails. Now, if you're using four or more disks using RAID 5, there is also a simple way to calculate parity just by adding up all the bits. And if the sum is an even number, then the parity would be 0. If the sum is an odd number, then the parity would be a 1. So the first row, we have 1 plus 1 plus 0, which equals 2, and 2 is an even number, so the parity would be a 0. The second row, we have 0 plus 0 plus 1, which equals 1, and 1 is an odd number, so the parity would be a 1, and so on. And you would use the same calculation to rebuild the data if a disk fails. And also, just like in our previous example, the parity would be evenly spread across all the disks. So guys, I want to thank you for watching this video on parity. Please subscribe, leave a comment, and I will see you in the next video.